I'm not going to belabor the point, but I do strongly believe there is a role of government and there is a role of a family that has to make that decision. As it was already laid out today, that we kind of got a view of both sides. And with either of those decisions, I still don't see where I fit in to that conversation as a legislator. Because a family, at the end of the day, have to live with whatever decision they choose to make. And that mother who was told that her fetus was deformed and potentially would be born and lose its life to a horrible, crushing death of its organs and its bones, that is not a decision that I want to be in charge of telling a family that they do not have options. I am not a woman, let's make that clear, that I will never have the opportunity of carrying a baby. So I will never have the feeling of a woman who has the potential of giving birth. Therefore, I should not have the right to tell a woman which they can and cannot do with their body. But it brings me to more of a critical point. There's a time in history when we did not have clinics. We did not have doctors who perform these operations. So it makes me caution that if we put certain restrictions on a woman's choice, will they start looking for that other option? And if this bill intent is to protect women's right and women's health, how are we protecting women when we are taking options off the table that we shouldn't be making in the first place, which may make them look to seek those back alley clinics who we know exist? And we're putting more women in harm's way. I do not have the statistics in front of me, again, because this particular hearing came up so quick, we were unable to gather all of the actual facts. But there is millions of women over the years who have lost their life to these particular practices. And I do not want to see us going backwards when it comes to reproduction rights for women by saying that we're going to limit you to 20 weeks, 6 days, when everyone has testified that your ultrasound is roughly around that 20th week, when you can determine, well, when a doctor, someone who, again, I'm not a doctor, determines if you're going to have a healthy baby. And sometimes we have deformity within birth, and these are acts of God, which I can't explain. But one of the things I can't sit and listen to is we have an argument about when life starts and we don't have the right to end life, but we have the same argument when it comes to death penalty moratoriums, but we don't have the same pro-life discussion. In my opinion, that's hypocrisy. You being pro-life and then pro-death penalty, so we get to choose when to take someone's life based on a crime they commit, but a woman doesn't have the choice to choose. That to me seems far-fetched, and I think this conversation should have a hearing. I think it is rushed, considering that Friday this was filed, and we're here now on Monday afternoon discussing an important issue that can come up for a vote as early as next week. I think this is being rushed, and I will be a no on this bill. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.